The forests of Madagascar are known for their amazing diversity of life. Here in Ankarafantsika National Park, you might expect the lemurs and chameleons to rule the trees, but actually, some of the most amazing ant species on Earth are found in this dry forest. And on this adventure, we're following them into the canopy.
I'm Miles Maxcer, myrmecological detective, biologist, and adventurer. I've been keeping ants for over a decade and seeking out intriguing insects for even longer.
Check this out.
Follow me as we discover the hidden secrets of the undergrowth.
I'm here in Madagascar as part of a research expedition being led by Dr. Bonnie Blamer from North Carolina State University and Dr. Brian Fisher from the California Academy of Sciences. We're surveying this dry forest for the ant species that are found here. Dr. Blamer is leading our arboreal collection project, and she taught me that you have to use different tactics to find ants up here in the trees than you can use down on the ground. Earlier, we were using sardine baits to try and capture foragers that were going up and down the trees, and now I'm heading up farther into the canopy to find what ants are actually living up here. It's so awesome to be here in Madagascar surveying the canopy ants. There's never been research done in this area of what kind of ants actually live up in the trees in this dry forest. This has got to be the craziest thing I've ever done to find ants. So one of the best ways to find ants up here is actually just to take a moment and pause and watch the branches. You'll see the foraging ants walking around. What I've actually done here is I sat and watched for a little bit, and I think I found a nest of Tetraponera. Now, Tetraponera are an amazing pseudomyrmecine ant found here in the tropics. Many ants live in twig nests up here in these trees. So what I'm going to do is send this twig down so we can get some closer shots of the amazing ants that are living inside.
Tetraponera are commonly known as slender ants. Their streamlined bodies are perfectly adapted to life in the trees, where they nest in twigs or cavities that special plants create for them. These plants are called myrmecophytes, and they have a mutualistic relationship with ants. Inside the cavities, the ants tend their growing brood.
As I was making my descent down, I noticed that there was a line of black ants moving along this part of the tree. These are Paratrachina longicornis. They're not actually native to Madagascar, but they're almost omnipresent in this dry forest. They've been carrying brood items for some time, and I even saw that they were carrying a termite. So we learned that the ants up here in the trees even predate on animals like termites, which might even be up here as well. Today we explored the canopy. Tomorrow morning, we're going to check out the understory and the soil to see more of Madagascar's unique ants. This morning, I'm working with a team of biologists to survey the ant diversity here in a patch of dry forest. We're taking a look at the ants in the soil and then also the arboreal ants living in the lower areas of the understory of this forest. But first, we're going to take a look at this massive Aphenogaster ant colony.
As we observe the nest, an unlucky beetle larva stumbles by. This provides the voracious foragers an opportunity to demonstrate their wicked powers of predation. In a matter of minutes, the workers have incapacitated the larva, dragging it over a meter back to the nest entrance. A single ant could never have taken down such formidable prey, but by working together, they overpower their target and bring it to a swift end in the nest.
These are some of the largest ants here in this area of Madagascar. You can imagine that there's probably over 1,000 workers and lots of brood deep in the colony. Dr. Brian Fisher actually measured a colony once, and the hole went down an entire 3 meters, and then the colony branches off into tunnels and chambers down below. That single grub certainly won't be enough to feed them all, but a couple of grubs like that and some other scavenging throughout the day, and we can pretty easily see how these ants can survive, even in a dry forest ecosystem just like this. Breaking twigs can be a great way to find ants that are arboreal and semi-arboreal. So instead of looking on the ground and flipping over rocks and looking under logs, we actually find ants that nest inside twigs and in small cavities associated with trees. There's an art to finding twig nesting ants. What I do is I go through the forest and I look for dead twigs that might be resting in trees or vines. And then if they look hollow, break them apart. And then hopefully inside the cavities, there are ants. And here, I've opened up a beautiful chromatogaster colony. So just as I was saying, they hollow out the twigs that they find here in the forest. And they usually prefer the ones that are suspended above the forest floor, but that are still kind of dead twigs twisted up in the branches. Inside this colony, I can see that they've got a large number of larvae. The chromatogaster are trying to kind of sting me, but they have a different sort of stinging mechanism than most ants do. While most ants might kind of lodge their stinger in your hand or the fold of a skin, what chromatogaster do is they make a small incision with their jaws and they actually dab the wound with venom at the end of kind of their stinger organ. Unlike ants that live in the soil or under rocks, these ants actually put all of their brood right along the chambers inside of the twigs. And then they bring the prey items back down and line it up, and they feed the larvae that way. The queen is usually in one of the twigs, generally in one of the larger sections of the twig nest. Some species also have satellite nests where there will be multiple twigs in one area that the ants actually are inside, but they may have the queen only in one of them, and then they transfer the brood and their workers over to the other nests over time. This part of our team, led by Dr. Brian Fisher, is currently going through a soil section here in the dry forest. And what they've done is they've dug a pit down into the soil, and now they're shaving away the sides of the pit with the shovel and some trowels, and they're searching for ants. This is a great way to find soil nesting ants, army ants, cryptic ants that you're not going to find here above the surface, but they'll be down deeper in the soil where there's moisture and alternative food sources.
While digging, the team uncovers one of the most unique ants on Earth, snapjaw ants in the genus Mystrium. The daylight is fading, so I head back to the field shelter to observe these stunning specimens under the microscope.
The genus Mystrium are known for having the fastest mechanical action of any living thing that we know about. My friend Dr. Adrian Smith found that the snap of its jaws is actually the fastest action any animal can produce. This is the ultimate snapjaw ant. It uses these specialized jaws to capture these amazing blue centipedes that are found here in Madagascar. They are also known as Dracula ants. Their sinister ways are exposed inside of the colony, where they actually cut open their own larvae and drink the hemolymph, or blood. This doesn't actually appear to harm the larvae, and it seems to be one of the primary sources of nutrition for the adult ants. Another of Mystrium's mysteries is that there's actually an even split in the nest of workers and queens. The workers are actually larger and black, whereas the queens are smaller and red. There's only one reproducing queen in a single colony. And when a colony of Mystrium actually gets too large, they split into two, and one of the other queens becomes a reproductive as well. This is a process known as budding. Now that the sun has set, I'm going to prepare for a night walk. Who knows what kinds of amazing wildlife we might find at night here in the dry forest of Madagascar. Looking at night here in the dry forest is one of the best times to try and find chameleons, because as your light goes across them, they sort of reflect back. I came across this Ophinogaster nest earlier today. It's pretty interesting to see that they are still active at night, even though the temperatures have dropped significantly. On your own explorations, you might notice that some ants are only active during the day or during the night. Animals that are active during the day are called diurnal, whereas animals active at night are called nocturnal. It's pretty interesting to see that these ants seem to be always active here in Ankara-Fonseca National Park.
Few places on Earth offer such unique biodiversity and opportunity for adventure as Madagascar. By joining the lemurs in the forest canopy, we found aggressive tetraponera, and we learned more about the invasive black crazy ants. By digging alongside the chameleons, we found the world record holding snapjaw ants. I can't wait to return to the island, and until then, thanks for watching this episode of The Ant Explorer.